Kia ora, I'm Erin J. Doyle. Welcome to my channel. This video is going to be a haul of all the books that I acquired over the Christmas period, and if I remember, additional channel related blah blah at the end, but we'll see. I'm kind of running out of time to film this. So, on to the consumerism. First, we have As Long as the Lemon Trees Grow. I picked this up because I just needed something to read while I was in Brisbane Airport, and I recognised this title from BookTube last year, so I picked it up. So far, based on the 108 pages that I have read, it is about a young person in Syria who was studying towards becoming a pharmacist when war broke out, and as one of the few people around who has any kind of medical education, is now working in the hospital performing surgeries and trying to help all the people who are being hurt during this conflict, but is still a very young person. She's not even in her 20s, doesn't have a full medical education, never intended to become a surgeon, but that's what she's now doing. So she's got a lot of chaos happening there, and then there's the conflict between the feeling that she needs to stay and help her people, help her community, but also the great desire to get the hell out of there with her one remaining family member. So she's having a little bit of a mental health crisis, shall we say, and so far it's keeping my attention. So I don't know what else I was going to say. It's gone. Moving on. Next we have The Day of the Triffids. I actually know pretty much nothing about this. I have a vague feeling that there's like evil plants or something. I don't know. I'll have to read it and find out. Next, I have a couple of books which I bought in an Australian bookstore because you can't get them in New Zealand. So I picked up Jade City just so I didn't have to go to Amazon. I know very little about this one again, but I know that so many people are reading it and enjoying it, so I was like, yay, I will join the bandwagon, for the same reason that I also picked up Poppy War. When I got this, I was like, oh no, I've never seen that in a New Zealand bookshop, I better buy it. And then I got home and immediately saw it in the bookstore and I was like, is this a new thing that's only just been for sale, or have I just been randomly blind to it for months? Who knows, but at any rate, I picked it up. And lastly, I picked up Winter Keep. This is the fourth book in a series that I have been reading, and the other three books I did manage to successfully buy in a New Zealand bookstore, but there was an issue where they changed the covers between the first three books and this one. So I had the option of keeping old covers that wouldn't match this one, or buying the three other books in the newly released version that does match this. Oh, the consumerist struggle. So I decided to buy the other three books in the matching covers, but then I had to wait for this one. I will remove the price tag. I had to wait for this one to come out in its second printing because it was originally released in this big size and my other three are in this size, and I didn't want to have the size jump. So I was waiting and waiting and waiting, and then the entire series disappeared from my local bookstore. So when I saw this in the new cover and in the shorter size that matched my other three, I had to grab it. I have gushed about this series previously, see other videos for details, I guess. Okay, I also at some point, I don't know when, picked up Dragon Keeper. This is one of the three books by Robin Hobb that I have not read, so this is just me finishing it off. This is the first of the three books. She kind of, if you're not familiar, kind of writes trilogies, but they all fit in with the same world and they are just kind of following on a big series, but in theory you could read each set of three individually. So this particular trilogy follows on from the ones about the live ship traders and focuses more on the people in the Rainwilds and the dragons and that kind of thing. I believe there is a little bit of crossover with the Farseer books, just because in one of the Farseer books they reference stuff that I think might actually be more relevant to what's happening in here. Not 100% sure, won't know until I read it, so we will find out. Don't fall over. Okay. Next we have a Christmas present from my sister's cats, The Book Eaters. As far as I'm aware, the title is self-explanatory. I know nothing else. Another Christmas gift, we have The Improbable Life of Ricky Bird. I had not heard of this, I know nothing about it except what it says on the blurb, which is lengthy, but it says something about no one that loved making forts more than Ricky. A fort was a place of safety and possibility. It shut out the world and enclosed her and Ollie within any story she wanted to tell. Blah blah blah. A wise, tender, but unflinching portrait of an ordinary family and an unordinary girl at its heart. I don't know. I will find out. I will tell you more. And finally, we have Legends and Lattes. I picked this up in the Auckland International Airport because I had a rough day, let's say. I think my original flight was, I think, 2 or 3 in the afternoon, and because of traffic and house sitters and things, I had to go to the airport slightly early. So we got to the airport at like 11:30. So not horrifically early. We were able to check in, so it wasn't, you know, hours and hours, but a little bit longer than the 3 hours I think it is recommended before an international flight. But then our flight was delayed and delayed and delayed and delayed, and I ended up spending over 5 hours in the airport. So during that 5 hours, I was traveling with my mother, and I was able to ride on her coattails into the business lounge, which I don't normally have access to, so at least I had somewhere nice to sit. But I was reading, Unsheltered at the time. Now, this is a New Zealand book, but set in an Australian-like future where everything's gone to shit, basically, and it's really stressful. There's a main character who's lost her family when the camp that they're staying in gets bulldozed. Like, they're in kind of like slums outside a major city, and it gets destroyed, and she gets separated from her daughter. Her husband isn't there, but we don't know why, and now she's on a mission to go find her daughter. It's all very tense and stressful, and while you're waiting for a flight that is getting delayed and delayed and delayed and delayed, it just wasn't kind of vibing with the mindset that I needed to be fostering whilst being trapped in the airport for hours on end. So I popped down to the bookstore and picked up Legends and Lattes because I knew it was sort of cozy fantasy, and I thought, this is gonna be better for my brain right now, and it was a good decision. I very much enjoyed this. So that's everything that I acquired, whether by gifts or lack of self-control over the Christmas break. And I think that's the end of the haul. Was there anything else I needed to cover? Yes, I wanted to do blah blah. So, the blah blah. Over the last few weeks, I've been thinking a lot about what I want to do with my channel in the coming months, and I made a list of videos that I'd like to film, and I split it into writing related and book related, and I realised that the book related list was actually longer than the writing related list, which isn't ideal when your channel is supposed to be AuthorTube, not BookTube. And I really always wanted to, or intended to at least, keep the books to a minimum. I wanted to talk about them a little bit, but mostly just kind of as filler and an FYI, life update kind of thing, not as a main focus thing. But obviously I have a lot of book-related ideas, and I can't help but notice that my book-related videos get significantly higher views than my writing-related videos. Conversely, my writing-related videos get greater interactions. I get more likes, I get more comments. Because my channel is so tiny, I don't have very much data to make any decisions with that observation. Like, there's nothing statistically significant about it, it's just like, I seem to have more of one than the other. So what I have been pondering is, if I have content which more people are interested in, so the book related stuff, but potentially the people who are interested in that content aren't going to be interested in the writing stuff, do I separate the two things out? They do say that you should have your channel be kind of focused and not be all over the place with your content to help the algorithm figure out who to advertise you to, kind of thing. So maybe it would be my best interest to separate the book stuff and the writing stuff. I can possibly assume that a certain number of people who watch my videos for writing related content might also follow me onto a second channel for book related content, but I do suspect that some people start watching my channel and subscribe during periods like when I'm doing my banned book reading, and then they unsubscribe when I then flick over into NaNoWriMo content. So maybe I separate the two, is what I am thinking. Perhaps there wouldn't be a significant loss. I don't think anyone's going to suddenly unfollow a channel that's currently about writing if I move the book related content onto a different channel. However, that's more effort. Because, I mean, in the last year, I haven't been making videos weekly. It's kind of been like fortnightly, kind of maybe, because of being really, really busy and really stressed. And oh my god, I have been sick. Needless to say, I've been very drained and struggling a lot for the last year. So the idea of then separating my content into two channels kind of makes sense from a marketing perspective, but maybe it doesn't make sense from a general workload and stress perspective. But then I am feeling slightly better these days. What do I do? I don't know. And have I explained this well enough in this video to share this and ask for your feedback, or am I just gonna delete it? I don't know. So I guess that brings me to the end, is I haven't made a decision. I have vague thinkings that it might be wise to separate my content out into book related and everything else, but I haven't committed. And I guess I'm interested in knowing what you guys think. You are the ones who would be immediately affected potentially if I did something super weird to the structure of my channel. But that being said, I'm asking for your opinion whilst making no promises. Because I may go, oh, that's an interesting opinion, but it's hard. So let me know what you think anyway though. I'd be interested to add it into my general percolating and pondering this topic. And now I'm going to run off and get food to go along with the assorted medicines that I need to ingest. Yep. If you have made it this far through the video, I am impressed by your perseverance through my chaos. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, comment down below to let me know what you think of the blah blah, and also if you have read any of the books that I talked about earlier and think I should put any of those onto the top of the TBR stack, which is almost as tall as me, and I will see you next time. Bye!